noće zaista imamo ekskluzivnu emisiju, ekskluzivnu šahovsku seansu. Pre svega želim da najavim mog neverovatno popularnog gosta, čoveka koji je bio živa legenda šaha, to i jeste danas svetski prvak, Anatoli Karpov. Good evening, Tolja.
Good evening.
How do you feel in Serbia now?
Okay.
Like always, nice.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming here. Drugi gost, pored Anatolija Karpova, takođe legenda. Posle ću vam sve reći o moj otac koji je bolje verziran u biografije koga je sve pobeđivao. Uglavnom čovek koji je poznat ne samo da pobeđuje, nego i da savršeno peva. Gospodin Portić, good evening.
Good evening.
How it looks now? Belgrade better? Like before?
I didn't have a time really to look around.
No sightseeing at all?
No, not tonight. It's dark. I think exactly as noisy as it used to be.
Oh, yes. Thank you very much for coming here. I moj treći gost, takođe nekad šampion Beograda, najbolji šahista među političarima i čovek koji, ja mislim da skoro nije imao priliku da od nekog izgubim. Dobro veče, Aleksandre, pomoćiš mi noćas da časkamo sa zaista zvezdama šahovskim?
Dobro veče, ali ovo je malo pretarano, nisam nikakav šampion.
Dobro, meni tata rekao, šta sad?
Ne, nekad kao klinac sam onim...
Pionirski prvak bio.
Pionirski prvak, Ketović, nema si skroma.
Kućama takmičenja neko, ali nekad dobio drugu kategoriju.
Ali znaš puno o šahu, osim što igraš fantastično, tako da ćemo...
Ne igram fantastično, Voja Šešelj igra bolje od mene, ali igram, volim da pratim šah i...
I vezan je za Bugojno, isto?
Da, pratio sam sve turnire u Bugojno koji su bili 15. kategorije, sad ih ima
i... I nismo se tamo upoznali, vidiš, iako sam ja odrastala.
I tamo su igrali i gospodin Karpov. Moram da kažem za gospodina Karpova, on je sami popularni šahmatist Srbije, bolje malo i na ruskom, a ne samo na engleskom.
I veliki prijatelj, zaista.
Za gospodina Portiša, jeste gospodin Karpov veliki prijatelj srpskog naroda. I meni je zaista nevjerovatna čast da večeras budem sa ovim ljudima i sa ovakvim šampionima u istom studiju.
Hvala ti, ja sam sve uradila da ga izbegnem, ali on je neizbežan, Dimitrije Bjelica, koji će nam noćas za početak, za one nove klince koji su došli reći samo kratke biografije Toljine i Portiša.
Ti smo mi na vi ili ti...
Mi smo večeras na vi, gospodine Bjelica.
Ja mogu da kažem da smo okruženi stvarno velikim legendama. Čovek koji je u istoriji šaha dobio najviše turnira, 170 i...
Nije, još nijed.
Znači,
165. Evo, počinju problemi.
165.
165.
Na 165, tek na drugom mestu je Aljekin. To je koji još nije došao do stotke. Inače, dakle, i držao i titulu šampiona sveta, i ambasador UNICEF-a, i veliki prijatelj naše zemlje.
Uvek i u najtežim trenucima.
I nas dvojica smo inače... Imamo 10 dečijih šahovskih olimpijada.
I za gospodina Portiša, za one klince koji znaju.
Gospodin Portiš je jedna od najvećih svetskih legendi šaha. Recimo, on je ne samo višestruki šampion Mađarske, ne samo da je dobio veliki broj šahovskih turnira, nego u vreme kada je i Fischer bio u velikoj formi, pa kada su pravljene rang liste, to Matulović pravio rang listu, onda je stavio Fischer, Portiš, Larsen. Međutim, kada je onda Fischer prestao da igra, onda je Portiš bio broj jedan izvan Rusije.
Hvala.
Znači, jedan je bio izvan Rusije, broj jedan, a ovo je bio broj jedan u Rusiji. Prema tome, došao vam je celo.
Inače, evo, jedna mala takođe ekskluziva pre emisije. Gospodin Portiš je rekao, kad sam je uzela pletivo, da davnih 70. godina, gde je to bilo, u Londonu?
Palma de Mallorca.
Palma de Mallorca. Ko je protestovao? Fischer je protestovao?
Fischer, da.
Je li čija žena štrikala?
Sattles.
Sapla, tog nisam upoznala.
Oh, what you are doing now?
He was the Canarian.
It doesn't disturb me, but it certainly disturbs me.
Okay, now we go in English. So, Alexander, do you have a question for my guest tonight? What is the first question for Tolja? You don't have a question? You have, okay.
Well, I do. How many times you've been to Belgrade?
Oh, it's interesting.
Until now.
Well, it's very difficult to count.
Hundreds.
Hundreds of times.
No, not hundreds, but maybe 50, 60 times.
So, you saw many changes. So, can you tell me, it was just a brief visiting, but can you tell me how Belgrade looks now?
No, It's difficult to judge because we were in Novi Sad. Uh-huh. And we just arrived to Belgrade, so I can't say. But actually, we stay in a new hotel, which is.
He prefers Novi Sad.
Okay.
No. What we just discussed with Lajos, that Belgrade is very nice city. I like I like to walk on this street, fantastic street in the center, and I like Belgrade and nice rivers, fortress. So.
Thank you. So let's speak about chess. What happened with chess? Is it chess popular like was before, or something happened like with rock and roll? Rock and roll is not such popular like it was before. Did something change with the internet or after Bobby and you and all these matches between you and Kasparov? You know, nobody knows actually after you and Kasparov what happened with chess.
No, actually, chess was in crisis, mm-hmm. and professional chess is still in a crisis.
Mm-hmm. And, why?
This crisis started. Actually, chess players are guilty because they participated in destruction of world chess championship system.
Mm-hmm.
And at certain moment, chess players thought that they could eat from two tables, you know. But then both tables disappeared.
Yeah. True. So, who is the bad guy? Who is actually part?
Not me.
No, I know it's not you. But who should you tell that's the bad guy? Really, who is guilty?
No, actually, what happened that you know, Fischer started to build up the system with big prizes.
Mm.
Then
it was good.
Yes,
for you.
He stopped to play chess,
mm-hmm.
and it was difficult for me. But I became world champion, and then I continued. And Lajos would not give me to lie that the best times, the best prizes were probably end of 70s, 80s for the tournaments.
Is it true, Lajos?
I really don't remember because there is such a devaluation also in money, so I don't remember in prizes.
More tournaments than you remember.
I remember
great tournaments.
No, I would say that at that time there were more serious tournaments actually.
Mm-hmm.
Because nowadays there are these so-called opens. Where many players can participate, and there are really very few traditional tournaments. For example, there used to be great tournaments in Sarajevo. Yes. Sarajevo is still going on.
Yes.
But the Hastings and Hastings is much weaker than it used to be.
Yes. Mm.
And Vikings is actually, and perhaps Linares, the only traditional tournaments now. And now look around, there are no normal individual tournaments. Only
but why?
Big opens.
Why? Who is guilty? Organizers? The players?
No, okay. Maybe
let's be open.
Maybe
that's such a talk
maybe
show.
Maybe you will say that I'm trying to present Kasparov in a negative way, but actually he destroyed the system.
Mm-hmm.
He destroyed the system because when he became world champion,
greedy. Maybe he was greedy.
A little bit, but he wanted to have full control.
Mm-hmm.
And when you have system mm-hmm. and qualification, so it's difficult to choose to dictate. Mm-hmm. But when you have disorder or chaos, then world champion has a lot of opportunities. He can choose opponents. And so Kasparov wanted this. And because of his ideas, he tried to destroy top of the chess world.
Why?
And he succeeded. No, because what
ego?
I said.
Too hard ego?
No, just to dictate his will,
mm-hmm.
to dictate his conditions. And at certain moment he could, but then everything collapsed. And so this now we see the result of of this activity, what Mr. Kasparov presented in Chess World.
You want to tell me something?
I'm completely out of story. I know nothing about it.
But you also see that something changing with chess.
Yeah.
It's not such a popular thing like
I got one serious question to Mr. Portishan. One silly question, of course, and one serious is, well, I noticed that there's no tournaments, I think really important tournaments that you take part in these days, and what is happening?
With you! Where are you?
Your participation.
This is not my own problem, actually. The problem is this is for those who are, let's say, they are in the second row, not in the very, those grandmasters who might not be in the first 10, among the first 10.
I see.
Because they really don't get invitations. just take a look now in vacancy.
Why? Because of money or something else?
No, the rating points. Well,
rating
you know,
points,
we Hungarians,
yeah.
Of course, I must say that we always invent something very... we have always invented the great things. No, no, no. We really have...
That was wrong.
No, we have invented yes. very great things. Yes. But also sometimes, because many, a lot of people do not know actually what ELO means. Do you know? What does that mean, ELO?
The no.
ELO
never heard.
No?
Do you know who the inventor of this system was?
No.
This is the important
Maďarko je izmislio taj sistem.
Maďarko, he was a great Hungarian professor, actually, who lived in...
What else did you invent, actually?
ELO Arpad, Dr. ELO Arpad.
Yes.
So and many people don't know actually what ELO means. ELO in Hungarian, it means living. Something is living. And even in Hungary, when people are reading the newspapers, ELO points, they think that these points are real something living animals over the board or something like that. No, right. This is just after the great professor. But the point was that, you know, the Americans, they always...
Champagne.
The Americans, they always count points.
Always, yes.
Always, always. And now, in America, there was a so-called scoring rating system. There are no two neighbors, you and Mr. Bialyts, okay, you are neighbors. And now he says to his wife, look, I have five more scoring points than my neighbor. Let me go to play a chess game on Sunday. And of course you get the permission, because five scoring points at that time, something important. But now this is really Mr. ELO Arpad, Professor ELO, thought that something new has to be done. So he really worked out a good system. At that time it was a good system. But now there is such an inflation, he knew that, but unfortunately he died. He couldn't improve the system.
Mm-hmm.
Now imagine just Anatoly, for example.
Anatoly, for example.
Now let's say, do you remember how many ELO points do you have now?
No.
What was your greatest?
Score?
It's difficult. I was never in favor of this system. So.
No, of course, I'm not in favor of the system either. But I'm just...
No, but what I can say, that in the time of Fischer...
Yes.
Fischer had the highest ELO points, 2780.
Uh-huh.
And at that moment, the second had 2710, maybe. It was big gap
Such
of 70
difference.
Points. Yes.
Yeah.
But only few. I think at that moment, Fischer and Karpov and probably Koishner, we had over 27.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now we have over 27, maybe 20 or 30 players.
Exactly, that's what I wanted world? To mean. Exactly, that's what I wanted to mean.
Yeah.
When I had my highest ELO rating was 2,650 or something like that. Yeah, and at that time I was third at the rating list. Mm-hmm. And now many players with this ELO rating probably are not among the first 30 or 40. So there's really a big, big inflation
Of everything.
Yeah.
Mm. And
now the organizers, although they might not know anything of chess, they just say, okay, this is the highest category tournament, 17, 18 or 19 category tournament. It doesn't really matter for them that who the players are, what sort of chess they play. They just count the points and the ELO points.
A nama je ostalo Isidora samo u magičnom šahu.
U magičnom.
Samo tu ima Srba koji mogu da pobede. Inače u pravom šahu nema.
There
are no Serbian chess players that can reach
Dimitrije,
that kind of level.
Dimitrije je bio svedok toga kako je baš tih 70. i 80. počelo da se u šah meša i politika, a boga mi i parapsihologija. Evo ovde su dva velika svedoka tih događaja. Ali kada je počela ta moda sa parapsiholozima? Ko je prvi doveo parapsihologa? Tolja, understand me.
Maybe Korchnoi, yeah. No, but actually many things changed, you know, and then in the old time world champions, they didn't have such teams like we had, and so nobody thought about parapsychology. And then, it was different role, different moral, and so chess players were...
Moral? What does it mean?
What does it
previše
mean?
Žena, previše
chess players
not?
Were not enemies yet. Let me say that.
Yes, chess players were not enemies. We have different organizers. Actually, I started my international life in 1966.
Mm-hmm.
And so for for almost 20 years, almost 20 years, I never had problems with organizers. We didn't have cheaters in the chess world. But later, unfortunately, I had two big cases. One was with a German journalist who used my name for commercial publicity, and he received money on my behalf. And so this was during communist time, and then I had to open court case in Germany. Fortunately, I won, and this guy happened to be in prison for 5 years. Okay, some punishment at least. I didn't get any money. And then another case was here, and it is still here. The case. Yes, there is company Laura, mm-hmm. and owner of this company, Zeljko Milošević, he's chess player a little bit, and so he was in the team. Mm-hmm. He was manager of the team and sponsor, and so he cheated chess players, he cheated me.
And so, Tushal, Alexander.
And so mm-hmm. this guy...
He's not in the prison.
Not yet, but I think he deserves. I think he deserves. And actually, you know, this—the problem. Probably, okay. I know how to earn money, so this is good amount of money. He cheated me, but the problem that with this money he can cheat other people, and so we must talk about such guys because they give wrong impression in the world. For Serbian people, for mm-hmm. Serbian business.
Evo, ne možemo bez skandala, vidiš?
Okay, ja sam slušao drugu stranu.
Da. Give me some lessons how to earn money, because I was always very naive economically.
Okay, this is special occasion.
Gospodin Bjelica može to da objasni, on je...
Anatolij danas rekao s Paskom, kaže... Da nije Spaskog, ja bi bio najlenjiviji šampion sveta.
Ali evo ima jedan gori.
No, in preparation.
In preparation.
No, I'm very serious when I'm playing, when I participate in the tournaments. Mm. But it was always boring for me to analyze, like Kasparov did. He analyzed almost till the end. He was very good actor, and so he could act, and Lajos know.
Lajos sing. He was
so,
a singer.
So Kasparov, everything was, I know many cases, especially in my matches. Everything was analyzed at home till winning position, but he was making some faces, grimaces, he is thinking so deeply. But at the end, we could see that everything was at home till move 35, maybe.
Reklame, pa se vraćamo da pričamo o onom drugoj strani šaha.
Kad ćemo da izgubimo?
Sad ćemo počnemo. Evo nas opet ovdje, da vidimo malo tu i smešniju stranu šaha. Znači da se setimo nekih anegdota iz tih zlatnih vremena o kojima smo sad pričali. Definitivno više nisu zlatna vremena šaha, ali mnogi klinci obožavaju šah, igraju ga, pa da vidimo je li ima nekih anegdota, Dimitrije, da se sećaš iz tog perioda, ti si ih sve znao i bio prijatelj.
Tolke
knjige je napisao, daj nam sad podsjeti nas.
Koja je ušla u sve anale, dakle bio je to... Čuveni turnir u Cirihu, 59. godina, onda vozili smo se stvarno, to je živa istina bila, ali ona govori da je Bobby recimo veliko dete i da je taj najduhovitija ličnost. Dakle, oni su nam dali ovog šofera, jedan Mercedes i ovaj je šofer naglo zaokrenuo, Bobby se stvarno uplašio i kaže škandal, mogli smo sva trojica da poginemo. Onda sam ja htio stvarno da ga utešim, pa ja onako tiho kažem, pa Bobi šta, da smo stradali, sve novine, sutra na prvoj strani pisalo bi poginuo Dimitrije Bjelica sa još dva putnika.
I on je to ozbiljno shvatio.
Miša Tač se grohotom smeje, a on, a Fischer meni sasvim ozbiljno, kaže, ja sam od tebe poznati u Americi. To je stvarno živa istina, ona govori...
A u jednom delu Amerike.
Da, jednom delu, apsolutno.
A kada je Lajos bio u naj, da kažem, čudnijoj situaciji ili najzanimljivijoj? Koji je njegov meč onako izazvao najveću pažnju?
Your most interesting match. You played with everybody.
Not everybody,
with the champions and so
on. Or something interesting behind the curtain.
Who was the unbearable one?
No, I cannot. I really don't remember. I had really so many matches. I just mentioned to Anatoly that I had a funny match with Mr. Hübner. That was probably one of my greatest favor, biggest favor, because Well, I cannot say that I should have won the match, mm-hmm. but certainly there was a certain moment at the match, the score was even, and later I was told that at that moment, Mr. Hübner, Robert Hübner, perhaps you know him, but sometimes he's a great man, actually, but sometimes he's very strange.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes, but, I know.
But at that time, his luggage was already ready. He already packed everything to his suitcase. He wanted to leave. He wanted to resign the match. But unfortunately, he had a very good sponsor, a very good supporter, who convinced him to stay. And then I started to play very badly, and I lost the match, where I had all the chances to win. So yeah. I think I can never forget that match. Mm. Yes. Because then I was very close to him. Then because Korchnoi was in a very bad shape at that time, mm-hmm. and I really was very, very, very strong at that moment. I really don't know why I lost that match against Hübner, because then I qualified against Spassky, who was probably he was the most unpleasant opponent to me.
Yes.
And because we are about the same age, we don't speak about years anyway. But
but still it's secret.
Not secret. Yeah. But still, we are more or less. There is only a few months mm-hmm. among us. And when we started to play together, he was already a grandmaster, and I was just a beginner. And of course, for a long, long time, I never could have win. I could never win a game against him. Yeah. And then suddenly, there was a friendly match between, I think, the selection of Budapest and at that time the selection of Leningrad. And we had two adjournments, and in one adjournment I was completely lost, but in the other one I had winning chances. But now the captains came to me and said, let's make two draws. No, I said, no, I certainly must win at least one game against Boris. So I managed to win a game at least, and then since then, more or less we are approximately even score. Mm. And then in our second match I could qualify. Mm. So yes. Then this is probably my biggest success, because then I was very close to Anatoly, and I was really in good form, good shape at that time, and just Robert Hübner stopped me.
Tva šahovska grada imaju puno anegdota, su Bugojno i Linares, i oni su se pobratimi.
I Tilburg i Vajkanze, to su bili kao
Tilburg, Vajkanze, jeste, i onda je Robert Ben, mene, pošto sam ja organizovao za pet turnira u Bugojnu, poslao mi je telegram, kaže, kako da sletim na aerodrom u Bugojnu? Tamo dvorim, da nema ni železničke stanice. A što se tiče
jeste,
Linaresa...
Jeste, ima tri Titove vile i medveda bilo.
To je tačno. A što Mikulica. Se tiče Linaresa, tamo je puno puta igrali i Kasparov i Karpov. I sad, na jednom od tih turnira, ja sam bio neko puta zamjenik u restoranu, Kasparov poručuje, nešto hoće da poruči, kaže on, kelner kaže, izvinite, kako se vi zovete?
On je uvek jastoga,
ne, jel? Ne, on je rekao, ja sam šampion sveta. A kelner kaže, izvinite, gospodine Karpov, nisam vas prepoznao.
Ja. Aleksandre, evo sada pre nego što se vratimo našim prvacima, recimo, jel vi tamo u skupštini igrate nekad šah?
Pa kako da ne, ima snimke. Ja imam snimke, ja sam igrao sa njim.
Ne, u skupštini ne igramo šak.
A mislim, ono dok jedete dole i to.
Ono prasetino
jagnjetino. Jagnjetino, to sve, da.
Ne, to dole je zaista više kao men za neki ozbiljan restoran. A ne igra sa šakom.
A nije bilo tih mečeva među partijama? Pošto znam da dosta ima ljudi koji...
A nismo igrali, u čemu je stvar? Znači, svako kad... Koji god turnir da napravite, niko neće da dovede ljudi iz partije koji će da igraju, nego sve neke sa strane koji nekog podržavaju, pa onda...
Tako da nismo izvagali u stvari.
To ispadno igraju majstorski kandidat protiv velemajstora, šta sad tu mi da radimo koji ne znamo ništa o tome.
Ja sam snimao u skupštini, pa sam igrao sa pojedinim, recimo...
A, testirao si, znači da.
Imam taj snimak.
I šta je tvoj rejting, kako ko tu stoji?
Recimo... Mičun je odlično igrao.
Mičunović dobro igra, dobro.
Dakle, onda sam igrao sa svim partijama, jer ja nisam ni jedna partija.
I onda si ih testirao.
Sam rasporedio. Šešelj mi je izvuko Remi, a Šešelj igrao isto meč sa Karpom.
To sam ja otvarao meč.
Da, on je otvarao, a onda kad sam igrao...
Koja je još partija?
Sa Majom, kaže Maja, pa ja ne znam. Ja ne znam kako ovo, ja kažem, Maja, bit će remi, nema problema. I onda
znači, dobro, pa gentleman.
Onda, da, onda sam igrao...
Ali ovaj, kad smo kod žena, Tolja, o tome se nikad ne priča. Vi stalno dajete intervjue, pričate o šahu, ali ja moram da priznam da sam kao devojčica to gledala. Žene puno vole šahiste. I ja sam lično gledala, evo i tebe, gde god dođeš u koje mesto, turnir, ti ne primećuješ, ali one te jure.
Da, da. To su pametne žene koje vole intelekt.
Da li žene smetaju šahistima i koliko može da se uskladi, da kažem, jedan normalan brak sa tako teškom stvari kakav je profesionalni šah?
Ну, в общем, конечно, если жена не понимает шахматы, и если она не понимает психологию и вообще, что во время матча, особенно первенства мира, должен быть абсолютно сосредоточен на шахматах и не можешь оказывать внимания. И если жена не понимает этого, то она мешает ужасно. Но мне в жизни повезло, у меня было две жены, и они обе понимали шахматы. И не было проблем с этим.
Да,
да. К счастью.
Хвала. For liars, the same question about women. women like chess players, but how the chess players like them?
Well, I think we are normal human beings.
You think so? Are you sure?
I'm just watching you. So, although I don't know if is it a secret or not. Do the spectators know your relation? I don't want to.
They know.
Serious business.
Yes, because
anyway, you are much nicer than your father.
Thank you very much. That's actually not a big compliment.
Mi smo bili u Valjevu, Anatolij i ja, i oni mi smo šetali i onda neka televizija tamo da nemo snima i onda pitaju oni, da li vi znate ko je Karpov, ko je Kasparov, ko je, onda jedan kaže, a da li vi znate ko je Bjelica? Pa kaže, to je Isidorin tata, tako meni je znači.
You translate him.
Da, tako me, tako me znaju.
Did you really ask?
He's well known in Serbia because of her.
But did you really ask him how high his rating was?
No, never, believe me.
Maybe higher than mine. I love, I've lost money in a point, but I really don't count. I even don't remember, just like Anatoly, because it's really not important.
Two years ago,
yes.
Ivko and me, they are open tournament in Benaske, and we got five prizes.
Yeah.
And then I said, in my country, nobody will publish this because people doesn't like if you are successful in abroad and so. But also,
okay, Egi, coming back to your question.
Very important question.
Yes. I have my second wife.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, my first wife died 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't know much about chess. She was only able to count the pieces.
Well, but not something. Bad.
And she accompanied me. We have been many times here in Belgrade, actually, together. Mm-hmm. So sometimes I look around with nostalgia, of course. And for example, when we were together in a so-called open tournament, and this was a rapid tournament. So I don't want to complain that I had no chances against Anatoly in a rapid chess, because even in an open tournament, I didn't have much chances. For example, in that first rapid tournament, open tournament in where was it? Luxembourg.
Luxembourg.
Yeah. I didn't win a prize, but I got a veteran prize.
Oh.
I didn't want to accept it, really.
Yeah.
I thought it's an insult, but yeah. My poor wife, she convinced me that Elias, if you got it, you must accept it.
Take it.
I was very angry. I was really, very angry. I really didn't want, well, a few hundred dollars or whatever it was. I really didn't want to accept it. So women are really very important.
And the second wife?
And the second wife, she's also very nice to me because
she's younger than you.
Of course, younger.
Of course.
Much younger, but I don't have to talk about
years, not important.
Not even my own years, but not especially not about ladies' years. anyway, when she accompanied me to an open tournament, mm-hmm. very early in the morning, I was still sleeping, as usually in the morning. So I went around to the first, it was Sunday, I remember, just in the middle of the tournament. At that time I had a rather normal score, but the round started around 9 or 10 o'clock in the morning. So I went round, I went down to the tournament hall and I sat down to a board. Somebody came to me, we started to play 5-6 moves, and suddenly another guy showed up. He said, "Gentlemen, excuse me, this is my board." So I was not sitting at the right board. And she didn't come because she was probably busy with her hair or whatever.
Of course.
And she didn't show up. And then from all the rounds, mm-hmm. she came down and she showed me where to be seated.
Where to sit?
Because I really couldn't watch where I was, where my mm-hmm. ranking was, so and so on. The women is very important.
Hajde da sada prvi put onako napravimo i neki uslovno rečeno rating po tome ko je bio najčudniji šahista. Tolja, šta bi bila tvoja lista intimna najčudnijih šahista? Znači, prosto tvojih top five.
Kod nas je Matulović bio najinteresantniji.
Ja, no, bil Brown.
И Браун исто.
Зашто? Okay, okay.
Фишер.
То ж ви знаємо, а що
він? Геніальний шахматист, но как психологическая личность, он очень интересен.
Veoma, да. Я сада морам да испричам заиста, пошто таква прилика. Я сам први пут упознала Бобија када сам имала 5 година. I on je stajao...
Ali nisi mogla drugi put da ga upoznaš, ali...
Ne, mislim, prvi put sam ga video. Inače, on se svaki put upoznavao ponovo, tako da nije tačna observacija. Stajao je u gaćama i moja baka mu je šila pantalone, pošto je štedeo na tome, nije htela da odnese na ušivanje. I moram da priznam, eto, svetskog šampiona sam upoznala prvo u gaćama, jeste. Ali što kako si rekao?
Brown.
Što on? Why him?
Браун уникальный был человек, совершенно. Когда он играл, то у него было, особенно в цейтноте. В цейтноте у него летали фигуры, он сам прыгал. Причем эмоционален абсолютно. Эмоционален был и очень забавно было наблюдать. Один раз на Филиппинах мы играли четверной турнир. Торе, я, Любоевич и Браун. И в одном туре мы играли с Любовичем, а Браун играл с Торре. И мы играли где-то в сельской местности, и там масса всяких бабочек, москитов. Вот, и Браун умудрялся играть в шахматы и ловить москитов, которые его атаковали. Мы с Любовичем играть не могли, мы смеялись. Вот, и просто, так, я думаю, что минут на 20 просто мы наблюдали за Брауном. Вот, никто из нас не делал ход.
Ко još ima tu reputaciju?
Да, я не знаю.
В истории?
Я думаю, что этих достаточно.
Да?
Но вообще Рубинштейн был такой сложный человек.
Угу.
Вот у него психические были аномалии, так скажем.
Дел да?
Да, код нас и наиинтереснее Матулович, а то, что он имел листу.
Какую листу?
Па листа везе са, то се у шаху зове B-турнир. Znači, A turnir je kad se igrao normalno, a ovo B turnir sa damama, je li tako? On imao listu preko 1000. I kad je bila olimpijada u Tel Avivu, onda je on...
Nego, kako je ta lista?
Imao je listu sa kim je igrao taj
magičan,
sa magičnim danama, B turnir, to se zove B turnir. I kad smo bili na olimpijadi u Tel Avivu, ja onda kažem, ja napišem, pismo i potpišem se kao neka dama, Marija, Dolores i tako dalje. I napišem njemu pismo, čekat ću vas u vreme meča Rusija, Jugoslavija ispred dvorane turnirske. I on kaže...
Kad šeta Matulović ispred dvorane.
Matuljko igra partiju, radi mu sat i dolazi u 6 sati, tačno dolazi i kaže meni, slušaj bre, neka lepotica me traži. Namešteno, a to je tako. Onda je on imao sve rangliste, sve moguće. A onda je on se čuven, u knjizi Velimajster izbiza, kaže Žadub, kad je napravio čuveno, vratio je potez, kao Kasparov. Meni Kasparov isto ne može da oprosti što smo snimili da je vratio potez.
Kad je to snimljeno? Koji je to meč?
Sa Judit Polgar je Kasparov vratio u Linaresu potez i organizatori nisu hteli da mi nismo to snimili. Svet nikad ne bi znao.
Stvarno. Tako i nije znao, i ti nije znao što snijati.
Da, mi nismo znali isto, nego kad smo gledali film, onda smo vidjeli da vrati potres.
Da vrati,
onda smo napravili. Kampomanes mi nudio pare da, da ne prikazujem. Ja sam rekao, njet, ja... Ja to, ovaj, ja to
prikupim.
Ja njih podkupim.
Ja podkupim, jeste, jeste.
Dakle, ove reklame, dotle će Vučić da smisli svoje fatalno pitanje. Da odigra meč.
Jeste, i Vučić je rekao isto ko je da najbolje igrao od, od ovih lidera i tako dalje. A onda vezano sa tim, mi hoćemo da se uključimo u, ovaj, u te takozvane dobitnike Oscara. A drugo, nas dvojica smo ovaj, nas dvojica
smo... Koja vas dvojica, ti i Tolja?
Anatolij i ja smo postali počasni članovi fudbalskog kluba Partizan. Ja stvarno moram da kažem da ovaj, dve ličnosti koje nas najbolje shvataju u ovoj zemlji,
to osim su meni, Ivan, Vučića,
Čurković, Ivan Čurković u Partizanu i Bojan Pajtić, predsjednik izvršnog veća Vojvodine. Ja znam da vi niste iste partije, ali on je igrao sjajno šah. Ali jedan lukavi potez smo odigrali prošlo.
Da uradiš nešto na nemogućoj koaliciji između Demokratske stranke i Srpske radikale.
Pa jeste.
Nema šanse.
Nema šanse,
kad je bila prošla, prošle godine olimpijada.
A evo nudim Pajtiću da igra šah ako izvuče remi.
Pa ćemo da organizujemo taj meč.
Ali on je igrao sa mnom magični šah.
E, magični može. Magični može na ovoj pravi teško.
Znaš kako je Anatolij mu rekao? Kaže, ajde predsjedniče, vi igrate sa Bjelicom magični šah. I ako Bjelica uspe da remizira, vi onda prihvatate sigurno da budete pokrovitelj 10. dečje olimpijade.
Lepo.
A mogao i da pobedi, da bude u dve naredne olimpijade.
On je već, ne, onda je bio je remi, stvarno on je žurio, dobro igrao, žurio je i igrana je 10. a sad smo igrali znači za 11. olimpijadu.
I šta je bilo?
Samo ljudi moraju da znaju šta je magični
šah. On
je imao
figuru više, dakle to je magična kocka koja se baca i koja figura ispadne, evo je lovac, ne mogu da igram lovca, onda protivnik baca. I ovaj, stvarno je odlično igrao i sad je odlično igrao i moja figuru više.
Ja sam samo zavisio sreće.
Ja sam lukavo.
To je mešavina šaha i pokera. Reklame.
Pa dobro. Normalan potez, a ja igram...
Ovdje se raspravljaju, gledajući da li će da igraju magični ili obični. Magija se svugde umešala i dok oni reše ko igra protiv koga, da li magično, da li...
Ja sve u magično pobedim.
Ti sve magično.
Ja ne umem magično baš dobro da igram.
Baš je igrao odlično, magično je imao sjajnu poziciju sa mnom.
Samo sam izgubio.
Ali posle je izgubio, ali dobro. Ja gubim sa magičnim
danom. Bolje su šanse s normalne šahmate, ne?
Tanja, šta misliš o onom...
Pošto su mi velike šanse u običnom šaku proti gospodine Karpova.
Bolje pređi na magični. Lepo ti kaže, Dimitrije, poslušaj.
Ne se magični, tu ima neke šanse.
Dobro, igrajte nešto dok ja pričam.
Malo, za svaki slučaj.
Za svaki slučaj.
Ja dobio džokera.
Ti dobio džokera.
Znači imam pravo bilo kojom...
Nije džoker na kralju, nego na kralju.
Jeste kralj.
Tanja, je se sećaš onog posljednjeg turnira zbog koga se ovo sve i desilo na kraju sa Fišerom na Svetom Stefanu, što je organizovao Gazda Jezda, Spaski Fišer.
Da.
Šta misliš o tome danas?
Eto, a ćemo, a turniri ili...
Da, da, da.
Bao tournament...
Taj veliki comeback Fišera, da li je to bila dobra stvar ili je to bilo kontraproduktivno?
No, it was good. Actually, they were not...
Tiše, bre, priča.
They were not in good form, both at the same games. So, some games Spassky was in good form, Fischer was in bad. Mm-hmm. Some games Fischer was in good, Spassky was in bad form. But still they produced maybe two very good games mm-hmm. in that match. Fischer won 10-5 and actually he was stronger, this is quite clear. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I think it was good. It was good
you
for chess, yes, it was good and I supported this.
Did you meet Gazda Jezda ever, no?
No,
no.
I didn't meet him.
Pričali smo o tome da li je taj turnir, evo svi ste to bili sa svedoci toga, da li je vredao taj comeback ili nije. Aleksandra, sećaš se i ti toga, jel misliš da je trebao taj povratak Fišeru ili ne? Na kraju je zbog toga i stradao, izgubio državljanstvo.
On je uradio u tom trenutku sjajnu stvar za našu zemlju.
Ali mi mu nismo evo dali državljanstvo.
Pa to je sramota ove vlasti i sramota ljudi koji... Nikada ne pamte što veliki ljudi urade za našu državu, a nije njegova sramota, on time može...
13. jula kad je on zatvoren, ja sam dobio poruku, bili smo u Igalu, i ja sam istog časa mu poslao garantno pismo, ali ja ne mogu dati vizu. Onda sam se obratio i ministru inostranih poslova, i predsjedniku države, i svi su kao bili obećali da će mu dati azil. Znači, sutradan su, kad su razgovarali, rekli ne može. Tako da on nije došao u Igalo, mislili smo da dođe u Igalo sa svojom suprugom.
Još jedan put smo se pokazali.
Sad je inače u Reykjaviku, bio je stanovao jedno vreme u hotelu, nedavno sam zvao.
A je on sad ima neku novu ženu ili nema?
Ne, ova je žena Japanka, ona je četvorostruka prvakinja Japana. Ona je vrlo interesantna i ona njega obožava, ona je njegova dama, ona je tako rekla. I on je sad iznajmio je specijalni stan. Ja ne znam, to mi je rekao da je to tajna, ali on ne, recimo, stvarno sad ne sme da igra, recimo, sa Karpovom jer se boji da će da izgubi.
Stvarno to, ja?
Pa nije, ja to znam, ja sam se uverio. Zato što sam dobio poruku, ja sam poslao ovome jednom...
Excuse me, how many minutes for the reklam?
No, now we are talking.
Yes.
Oh my god.
Nudili su velike pare, ali da se igra neka druga vrsta šaha. I on je sad promenio, sad iznajmio je stan, sad nije u tom hotelu. I rekao sam mu da će ovdje dobiti odštetu zato što su ovdje štampali
srebrenjake
sa njegovim licem.
Ne, možda tako bi zabrasnik.
Lajoš!
Ne, izvini. Izvini.
What are your plans? Chess plans? Do you have?
I have no chess plans.
No more chess plans?
To make such a bad move like he did.
What are your life plans?
I don't know if you know that or not.
No.
I have very serious plans in music.
Yes! Really?
Yes.
What CD or what?
Well, now of course, what sort of year do we have now?
Oh.
No, please, you must know that. It's very important. One of the greatest composers of human history.
Kasparov.
Nisi mi to rekao da Lajoš ima muzičke ambicije.
Kako pa danas je poklonio CD Gligi.
Pa dobro to, ali nisam znala da ima...
On je među najboljim pevačima. Oni Smislov su šampioni među velemajstorima u pevanju. A Tajmanov u klaviru.
Hoćemo moći da vidimo...
All the chess players like music very much. Love music very much.
Why? It's secret connection between...
Actually, there were many great musicians among the chess players. From the other side also,
so
how many may Oistra, for example, and
Shostakovich,
and also many others like Prokofiev was very, very great one,
also good player.
Prokofiev was fantastic. He was the strongest.
A Tajmanov izvanredna pijanista.
Znači to je ta čudna veza, vidiš, o kojoj nikad nije pričano. I sada, pošto se lagano bližimo i kraju emisije, da vidimo šta prognoziraju ovdje prisutni u studiju, šta je budućnost šaha, Anatoli. What is the future of chess?
I think it's good, because...
Yes?
Yes. So we have, as I said, we have crisis on the top for professional chess players, but we have more and more kids playing chess.
In Russia also now?
No, everywhere.
It's very popular.
It becomes more popular again. I cannot say we have reached the level of
basketball
the level of 80s when chess was very popular. But still, we improve, and so it's very good. We have chess in school.
Yes,
in many countries. So we started this program in Brazil.
Eto, dobra ideja da ubacimo šah i ovdje u škole, Aleksandre. Seksualno vaspitanje i šah.
Pa da, evo,
mislim, svi navalili s tim seksualno.
Pa nekako, mislim, prosto...
Bolje šah.
Inače, mislim, rešimo...
Nego da mi gospodin Portić pomogne šta da igra.
Mi smo, deči i šah...
Nudim Remi, upravo je.
Upravo
je gospodin Portić.
Nudi Remi.
Draw.
Odlično.
Unapredili smo...
Very good grandmaster draw.
Evo, dragi, lepo je završeno, srećno, Remijem. Lajoš. How do you see the future of chess?
Do I have to be honest, really?
Yes, please.
I'm very pessimistic.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes. Why?
No, not like Capablanco. I didn't reach that level like Capablanco when he lost his title. He said, "No, this is the end of chess."
Mm-hmm.
No, but really, I hate the computers, I must say, and they are really the killers.